Hello everyone, this is lecture 2, class 9th, subject English, subject verb concord. As you all know, we read around 14 rules in our previous lecture related to this chapter. So in this lecture, we are going to study three things. Recapitulation, that means a brief review of the rules which we have studied in our previous lecture. And then we are going to study more rules of subject-verb agreement, and then we will discuss the homework solution of the previous lecture. So let's start with the recapitulation. Recapitulation means a brief summary or revising the things which we have studied in our previous lecture. So there were rules. The rule one is, there were basic rules that singular subjects take singular verb, plural subject take plural verbs. You is the pronoun that always takes plural verb. Then we have, if two subjects, one single and one plural, are connected by either or neither nor, then the verb agrees with the nearer subject. Then next rule is, a singular subject followed by intervening words or phrases such as, with, as well as, in addition to, accompanied by, together with, and no less than, takes a singular verb. Next rule, singular subjects, when they are joined by and, they usually require a plural verb, but if they mean one thing, like bread and butter is a good breakfast, so when they are meaning one thing, then in that case we will be using singular form of the verb. Next rule, the indefinite pronouns several, few, both, many, others. These pronouns are always plural, that means they always take plural form of the verb. Next rule, expressions of time, money, weight and distance are singular even if the form is plural. Right? Even if their form is plural but the meaning is singular, then we are going to take singular form of the verb. Then we have last rule, that when any of the following indefinite pronouns, when these pronouns will be the subject, then the verb will be singular. Everybody, each, no one, another, anybody, nobody, every, nothing, everything, anyone, either, neither, everyone, somebody, someone. When these indefinite pronouns will be the subject, then the verb will be singular. So these were about the previous rules that we have studied. Now we will look for the more rules, the more leftover rules of subject verb. Next rule is, when the word is preceded by a, it takes a plural verb. When it is preceded by the, it takes a singular verb. For example, a number of students are waiting outside. That means if the word is preceded by a, it will take a plural verb. If it is preceded by the, it will take singular verb. The number of students outside is not recorded yet. So this was the difference. Now next rule, when fractions are used, the verb agrees with the object of the or phrase. That means when fractions are used, like one half, one fourth, one fifth, two third, then the verb agrees with the object which is used after the of phrase. Like one half of the cake was consumed, that means one half, that is a fraction. Now of phrase subject is cake, which is singular. So we have used singular form of the verb was. Now another example, 1/4, again fraction, and of phrase subject is employees. So 1/4 of the employees were, employees plural. So we have supplied plural form of the verb. 1/4 of the employees were attending the seminar. Understood? Next rule, these nouns may be singular or plural in meaning, like athletics, genetics, politics, gymnastics, statistics. They may be singular or plural in meaning. Now the rule says, when the noun refers to an organized activity, it is singular. That means when it is referring to one activity, though its form is plural, then we will be using singular form of the verb. When the noun refers to the activities of individuals within a group, now here the rules is saying, if it is referring to the whole as a one activity, that will be singular form of the verb. But if it is referring to the activities of individuals within a group or to varied activities, that is representing different activities, then the verb will be plural. For example, gymnastics is very popular among girls. So gymnastics here has been used as one activity, one organized activity, therefore the verb is singular. Now see the next example. The gymnastics shown in the field, that means there were different individuals who were showing gymnastics. So the gymnastics shown in the field today were outstanding. That means there were individual, it is referring to the individual member of the same activity who were performing there. So the verb has been applied here, the plural form of the verb. Understood? The next rule says, the name of a country, if its form is plural, then also it will be regarded as singular. For example, the Bahamas has beautiful beaches. It is the name of a country. So, the name of a country is always regarded as singular. Philippines is a wondrous place. So, Philippines, S is there. Form is plural, but it is the name of one country only. So, it will be regarded as singular only. Next, adjectives used as nouns are considered plural. For example, the poor are to be helped. Poor, he is very poor. Here poor has been serving as adjective. But if such adjectives are used as nouns that refers to that particular class, for example, the poor are to be helped. Here the poor is not referring to one person only. It is referring to the whole class of this poor society, or we can say poor group. So the poor are to be helped. That means in that case, when adjectives are used as nouns, then plural form of the verb is to be used. The poor are to be helped. Next example, the efficient are what this country needs. So here the efficient is working as noun here. So which type of person our country needs? The efficient. So it is referring to the different people who belongs to this group, the efficient group. So it is working as noun. So in that case, we will be using plural form of the verb. Next rules. Collective nouns may be singular or plural depending on whether the individual members are acting individually or collectively. Now see, this rule says that collective nouns. Now what are collective nouns? That represents one group of same kind, right? That is collective noun. It may be singular or plural. That means it depends on their usage. If they are used as one, then in that case singular form of verb. But if we are talking about the individual members of that particular group, then in that case plural form of the verb is used. For example, the committee is against the plan. Then the committee refers to what? Particularly one committee, referring to one, singular meaning. So singular form of the verb is. Now next example, the committee are of different opinion. That means the members of the same community, talking about the individual members. So plural form of the verb, the committee are of different opinion. So there are collective nouns which depends on their usage, that whether the singular form of the verb has to be used or the plural form of the verb has to be used. Company, group, committee, crowd, jury, flock, team. These are the common collective nouns which are used. Next, in the use of mathematical expressions, the following are accepted. Now see, if the mathematical expressions are there, which are written in words, like 7 plus 3 is 10, right? In this case, we have used singular form of the verb. Now, 7 and 3 are 10. Depending on the meaning, 7 and 3 are 10. Similarly, 5 times 2 are 10. 5 minus 2 is 3. That means if we are using plus minus in words, then singular form of the verb. If we are not using mathematical expressions in words and we are using other words like and, times, so plural form of the verb. Next, titles of books, plays, articles, movies, etc. are regarded as singular even though words in the title may be plural. There are so many books, there are so many plays, articles and movies whose names are in plural form, right? But are they meant plural? No, they are singular. So we will be using singular form of verb with them. Example, in dreams begin responsibilities. This is the name of one novel. Is a story by D. Squads. So that means if the name of any book, title of any article or movies or anything which is plural in form, we will be using singular form of verb with them. Great Expectations is a must-read novel. Now again, it is a name of novel, Great Expectations. Form is plural, but the verb supplied is singular. Next, names of organizations take a singular verb when the whole organization is referred to, and a plural verb when the members are referred to, same as collective noun. If we are talking about one organization as a whole, then singular form of the verb. But if we are talking about the individual members of the same organization, then plural form of the verb. For example, Lopez and Sons is a successful organization. Now it is a name of one organization, and here also it is working as one, singular. So singular form of the verb. Now see the next example. Lopez and Sons are holding a 2-day annual meeting. Now here it is talking about what? The members, right? So we have supplied plural form of the verb. So it depends on the usage. It is similar to the use of collective noun only, right? Then the last use is, the last rule of subject verb agreement is that if a sentence begins with the expletive it, the verb is always singular even if the subject that follows the verb is plural. So if the sentence is beginning with it, then the verb is always singular even though if the subject is plural. For example, it is the school's. Now here the sentence is beginning with it and the subject is schools, which is plural, but still we are using singular form of the verb. It is the schools which must assume the responsibility. Another example, it is us who must take care of the environment. So when the sentence is beginning with it, then the verb has to be singular. Understood? So this was all about subject verb agreement. Go through the rules, 14 rules we did in our previous lecture and 10 more rules we did in this lecture. So total you have 24 rules with you, and you need to revise them. If you want, you can note them down with one example of each in your practice notebook, so that whenever you are going to revise them again anytime, you need not go through them again in sequence. You just have a look on those rules with one example, and definitely it will be easier for you to revise that time. So note them down in sequence with one example, because examples will help you to understand the rule correctly, right? So if you want, you may note them down. Otherwise, the rules are there in your grammar book also. So this was about the chapter. Now we have homework solution. I gave you 10 sentences, right, in the previous lecture. The question was that you have to choose the right form of verb from the given options. The first sentence, the pots on the table are beautiful, as plural subject, plural form of verb. Next, the detectives are investigating the case. Again, same thing. Next, one of the diamonds. Now here the subject is singular, but the phrase has plural subject. So, was. If the subject is singular, then what? Then singular form of the verb has to be supplied, even though the subject in the phrase is plural. One of the diamonds was stolen. Next, a number of videos have been deleted from the phone. Same. Next, a has been used. That means yes, according to the subject. Then we have 200 rupees seems a fair price for 2 bricks of ice cream, as 200 rupees with money, weight, distance, singular form of verb. Next, none of these flowers grows well inside the house. Next, not everyone wants to learn more and more. Everyone, there were indefinite pronouns, with them we are going to use singular form of verb. Neither of these printers work properly. Next, each of the employees is each, every, either, neither. When the subject, when the sentence is starting with such verbs or such indefinite pronouns, then singular form of verb. Last sentence, bread and eggs. And is used but meaning the same thing. It is comprising one dish. Is my favorite. So this was the homework solution. Now you, what will be your homework? Your homework is that you have to revise subject verb concord thoroughly. Go through the rules with each example and match your answers. If your answers are wrong, put a simple cross. And then do write the correct answers near to that only. And you are going to solve these questions or these 10 sentences in your English practice notebook only. Do mention the date, heading, sentences, and then match your answers. And revise subject verb concord thoroughly.